Well, I didn't want people to know that about me. I didn't want people to feel pity on me. And I don't know why. I don't know why I wasn't accepting the fact that people really cared about what was going on in my life. Like, and I didn't even allow myself to really feel like how much that hurt. Like, I didn't, not even just hurt, like I didn't let myself to feel any of those emotions. I was like, well, I mean, this is what I gotta do, and I kept moving. Like, tell me on the best diet, I'll be feeling like yes I am, I am. You know on the best diet, be a fool to not take me as I am. Tell me on the best diet, I'll be feeling like yes I am, I am. You know I'm the best I am. You be a fool to not take me as I am. Hey YouTube, this is Jessica Karina coming to you with Jess Help 101. Alright, today I just kind of wanted to go over with you just a little bit of kind of how I've been just receiving things as far as like after, you know, my breaking point, you know, what I mentioned last time. So it really just kind of sparked something in me to change. And the thing is, I had no idea what to change, how to change, what this mean, none of that. Like, just being completely transparent, completely honest to myself, I was like, how I've been dealing with life thus far is not working out for me. It's not. So, you know, what am I supposed to do? Like, I'm just living life the way I've been living. It's not working, so what do I do? Okay, so I feel like a lot of people, you know, my age, or just period, go through life, have this, and it's crazy. I feel like a lot of people stay in this position, stay in this stagnant, like, they just stay that way. They just plateau and think that's it. That's how life's gonna be. And that's where people just stop. Like, and I'm not here to tell, you know, like, you're living your life wrong. No, the whole purpose of me being, you know, being the way I am, being completely transparent, is just to let you know, even on social media, I may look like I got it all together, like, I'm, like, super successful, not saying that I'm not, but just saying, you know, like, people look at me in one way, and they don't even realize, like, I've had all this stuff that I've been going through. So that's the reason why I want to be super transparent, because a lot of people think that they should live up, like, I should be doing more, I should do this, and I'm like, no, you live your life the way you need to live your life. Stop comparing yourself to others, and I fall victim to that all the time. I'm like, I know, you know, my path is supposed to be different from everyone else's path, but I'm like, dang, like, I don't have the job that I want, like, I'm not where I thought I was gonna be at the age of 27, 28, like, what am I doing? Like, what am I doing wrong? So these are all like the thoughts in my head. So the first thing I had to do as far as regarding change is you shouldn't keep yourself in the past. Don't ignore the past. Learn from those lessons, but don't keep yourself there. Learn from it. Like, well, feel those emotions. Don't ignore those feelings, because that was a big thing for me. It's like, don't ignore those feelings, like, feel it out, but don't, like, bury yourself in there. Feel it out, learn what you're supposed to learn from it, and then move forward with that lesson. And that was the biggest thing for me, was that, you know, I never really just felt, period. that's just what it is. I never felt, I never allowed myself to be emotional. The only emotion that I'll allow myself would be, happiness, which is not bad, you know, you should always be happy, but I only, you know, allow myself to be happy, and then I would be sad sometimes because it was just so overwhelmed, but, like, I would never allow any other emotions to come through, and it was weird, and I didn't realize that. Also another thing, I realized after everything that was going on was that I kept everything at a surface level. I kept everything surface level. I would never dive deep. And not just with everybody and everything in my life, but like me, I didn't allow myself to be deep for myself. Like, I didn't, you know how some people, like, they keep their emotions to themselves, but at least they know what their emotions are. I had no idea. I just was not 100 with me. Like, so that's kind of how I had to start. I had to be, okay, it's time for me to dive deep into myself. Like, what is it that I need to change? Number one, I cannot keep a surface level with myself. I have to actually dive deep into me, figure out what is going on so that I can fix it. And so that's where I tie in the whole past thing, is because you gotta learn your lessons. And the thing is, like, yeah, from my past, yeah, it happened, it was bad, and I moved forward, but I really didn't move forward. I just put it on the back burner, and until it, you know, explodes again in my face, and then I put it back on the back burner until it explodes again, and I never really healed from it. Yeah, so I'm gonna tell y'all a story. So I was 15 years old. I was 15 years old. I was a freshman in high school. And just kind of a little background, like, I've always been, like, overachiever type person. I was in, well, back then I wasn't in all honors yet, but I was taking honors classes. I went to the high school to be in a performing arts. I was in choir. I was a cheerleader. I was in all these different organizations. This is my freshman year. Like, I just did it all. So, I had saved up this money, and I ended up buying a cell phone. And back then, this just dates how old I am. So back then, the cool cell phone out was, like, the little swivel phones. And it was the little swivel phones. Like, you just, instead of flipping it, like, you could just swivel it up. It was like a Kyocera something. Yeah, in fact, Kyocera. Who even remembers Kyocera? But yeah, so I bought it off eBay, and it was supposed to arrive at my house, you know, a few days later. And so the day that it was supposed, that it did arrive, I had a game that day. It was a basketball game. And yeah, it was a basketball game. I get a phone call from, I forgot who called me. Either it was my mama or my sister. I get the call that my house caught on fire. And I'm thinking, like, okay, put it out. Like, you know, what happened? Like, it can't be that bad. Like, what do you mean? They're like, we're just gonna come pick you up. And I'm like, okay. Like, I'm not really grasping any of this. And I'm 15, like, and I'm like, okay. Yeah, I was just really confused in that moment. So they pick me up and they're telling me, they're like, yeah, you know, the house caught on fire. Like, my brother was heating something up in our toaster oven, and it ended up being an electrical fire. He thought he put it out, and then when he went to go, like, he took a nap after he, you know, he warmed up the food and thought he put out the fire came back. And because, like, it's an electrical fire, the fire came back, and by the time anyone realized it, the whole back of the house was already on fire, so they couldn't put it out. So my brother and my sister were at the house. My mom was at work. And they had to rush out the house. I forgot who. Someone was asleep. I think my brother was asleep. So they ended up waking up. So they literally watched my house burn down. And the thing is, like, so I wasn't there to see it. I wasn't there to see it happen. But they were there watching the house that we've grown up in, you know, burn down. Now I'm at school, all this happens, and I'm like, I'm cheering at the game. So I finally get to the house, and I see that, like, my house is burnt down. Like, the front door, so the back of the house burnt down, and you can still see the front of the house, but I just remember that the front door was black. It was, like, smoke damaged. Like, the house smoke damaged. You could still smell it. If I remember correctly, like, we lived, like, around the corner from a fire department. But apparently our house was in that district for that fire department. So another fire department had to come to our house. And I thought that was the most stupid thing I've ever heard in my life. What do you mean? We literally lived around the corner from one fire department, and another one waited 20 minutes before the call, before they came to the house. So that's why the whole house ended up burning down, because it took 20 minutes from the other fire department to come get... It was a lot. It was a mess. And so everything was gone. And it was like my brother and my sisters, they were in my mom's rooms, were like towards the front of the house. My brother's was actually in the middle. So it was like there was towards the front, but mine was towards the back because it was like on the other side. So my room was done. Like, I lost everything. Everything was gone. And at 15 years old, like, you know, you're a teenager, you're very superficial, like, and the only thing on my mind was, oh my God, that phone I just bought was burnt down. I didn't even get to play with it. Like, I think about that all the time, and I'm like, wow. I was very superficial. And it didn't hit me because I didn't realize how much it affected me. Like, I lost everything. I remember that our insurance company gave us like some money to buy like clothes and stuff, and it had to only be from Kmart. It was weird. I was like, we only had one Kmart in Memphis, and that was around the time where it, like, Kmart was like no longer in existence, so I didn't realize we still had one. And then, like, they had to rebuild our house, and then we had like a budget as far as like appliances. Anyways, that was like after the fact, but they had relocated us into these apartments on the other side of town. And it was cool. Actually, the apartments were bigger than our house, really, because we lived in the hood. And so it was cool. It was fine. Like, you know, we were super blessed that, you know, all of us survived. None of us were like affected by the fire, like, cause smoke damage. Y'all have seen This Is Us. You just inhale that and you don't realize how much that gunks up in your body. So like, even though I wasn't in the fire, my brother and my sister had got out, it was like, you know, smoke damage is a lot. So none of our clothes could have been repaired. Like, we had to buy everything from scratch. Like, you don't realize how much stuff you accumulate over your life, and to start over, it's like, it's crazy. But then again, everything I was thinking was materialistic. And, you know, so my mom was trying to be like, you know, at least we're still here. All of us are still breathing. We're still healthy. Like, we can buy new stuff. We have insurance. It's fine. But even then, the insurance gave us, like, only the bare minimum of stuff they could, you know, allow us to get. And, yeah. So, like, since the present day, now that I am, like, aware of, you know, being conscious and, you know, being aware of who I am, I look back at that and I'm like, I didn't realize how much that affected me. Like, yeah, I lost everything, but I wasn't grateful. I wasn't appreciative of the life that was given to me after that. You know, I was like, oh, they're not gonna try to clean our clothes, and I have to buy new clothes. Oh my gosh, like, and then they're not giving me enough money. And I was just being so superficial, like, and I wouldn't tell anybody that my house burned down because I didn't want to be like a charity case. And I didn't want people to know that I literally had nothing. Like, I remember having to tell my choir director, because the type of school I went to, like, we performed like hundreds of times throughout the year. Like, so you need your choir uniform, and I didn't have it. The only thing that I did have were all my books and stuff and my cheer uniform. So that was the only thing I didn't have to buy. But I had to buy uniforms again. I had to buy my choir dress again. To buy my show choir dress. I had to buy a lot of stuff. But, well, I really didn't have to buy it. Because, you know, once I told him, he was like, oh, we have an extra dress. You know, just we'll pay for it to get hemmed. You know, it's like, whatever you need. And I eventually ended up telling my choir that I was in that, you know, that was what's going on. And so they were trying to, you know, give me money. And I was like, no, I don't want your money. No, I don't want your clothes. No, I don't want that. Because I was just so, I didn't want people to know that about me. I didn't want people to feel pity on me. And I don't know why. I don't know why I wasn't accepting the fact that people really cared about what was going on in my life. Like, and I didn't even allow myself to really feel like how much that hurt. Like, I didn't, not even just hurt, like I didn't let myself to feel any of those emotions. I was like, well, I mean, this is what I gotta do. And I kept moving. Like, I kept cheering at games, I kept performing, I kept going to school. Like, none of my teachers except my choir director knew what was going on with me. And then the reason why some people end up finding out was because my brother and my sister, because my brother and my sister literally didn't have anything with them. And so they had to get new books and they had to get new uniforms. And so, like, because some people knew them, then they end up knowing that, you know, I'm their sister, so I lost everything too. And I just didn't really allow myself to learn that lesson. And so now that I'm like, wow, like I went through a lot. Like, not many people lost everything at such a young age. You know, we were extremely grateful for, you know, being able to, you know, rebuild ourselves after that, because a lot of people don't. But it was just, I never realized how grateful I really was. And I never realized how much that affected my life. Like, maybe that's the reason why it's so hard for me to accept help. Because I wouldn't allow myself to accept help. Yeah, it's crazy. It's like, oh my gosh, like, I didn't want to be the whole, oh, woe is me. I didn't want to be crying in front of people. I didn't want people to see me weak. But really, now that I'm an adult, like, it's not being seen weak. It's being real. It's being transparent with yourself. People go through these things. Like, some people have it way worse than me. Or some people, you know, need to see that, you know, real things happen in life. And it's not, you know, the tragedy and the, you know, the whole, oh, woe is me aspect. It's, you know, what lesson is this that I need to learn from it? And how do I take this with me going forward? So, you know, that's just kind of how I see, you know, looking at your past. You could have the most traumatic things and tragedies that's ever happened in your life. But how you need to look at it is, okay, this happened, but I know people feel some different ways about, you know, everything happens for a reason, because some things you're like, there is no way that God allowed this for this to happen to me. And then there's other people that feel like, you know, everything happens for a reason, your story needs to be told, da 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 da, whatever, you know. So I feel like that you need to learn from everything that has happened to you. Feel it out. Don't ignore your feelings. If you feel sad, if you feel upset, if you feel frustrated, or maybe all of the above, you have all these things that are building up inside of you. Let it out. Feel it out. Don't block it. That's what a lot of things I also understand was when I say I kept everything at surface level. I would block and limit all the emotions that I have. And that should never be the case. Like, allow myself to feel and then accept help. Accept help. I was so blessed. The friends that I have back then are pretty much the same friends that I have now. They were very supportive of me. They wanted to make sure I was okay. They wanted to make sure it was like, oh, is there anything that we can do for you? Like, their parents and everybody. Like, I'm extremely grateful for my friends. Like, I'm just accept help. Accept that help. Because you know how they always say, you know, a village raises a child. And that's very true. That's extremely, I wholeheartedly believe that not one person can raise a child. Like, it has to be a village to raise a child. To accept the help and learn from that event and use that to go forward. Don't try to dig up your past. Don't try to like dig up emotions that you've already healed from. Don't try to do that. That just only like brings you back to that event, because energy and feelings are always tied up with events, and especially past, like your past events. So like if you've already healed from it, there's no reason to go back. But if you've not healed from it, feel it out, learn from it, and use that lesson to move forward. So hopefully that makes sense. Hopefully, you know, you get something from that. I have other things, like other things as far as other lessons with stuff, especially regarding the year of 2018, like what I've learned from. But that, just from that instance when I was 15 years old, like how I use that going forward, it's a different mindset, it's a different perspective, and it's helped me a lot, like conquering the things in my life now. And so it helped me, and if it helps you, then you know, I want to share that with y'all. I want to share you know with you kind of how things work how things work for me. See, it was 20, I'm 27, and probably when I post this, I'll be 28. This happened when I was 15. The fact that I'm just now learning from a lesson that happened when I was 15, like, you know, there's so many lessons out there that you probably never even realized that you came across. So, just trying to be completely honest and transparent. Hopefully this helps you out. Thank you for listening, and tune into my next video. And yeah, this is Jessica Karina coming to you with Just Help 101.